Dear students, in this video, we are going to cover the characteristics of hydrogen bonding. In the previous video, we have seen the formation of hydrogen bond, how hydrogen bond is formed. It is formed between the two different molecules, which consist of covalently bonded hydrogen atom and other highly electronegative atom like fluorine, nitrogen, oxygen, in between hydrogen bond is formed. Okay, so today we are going to see the characteristics of hydrogen bonding in this video. So first we are going to see, first characteristic is boiling point of water. Okay, as you are knowing, water, formula of water is H2O, and in my previous video also I have explained, in water molecule hydrogen bonding is present. Okay, water, actually water is a covalent compound. Water is a covalent compound. But during my explanation of properties of covalent compound, I said to you that covalent compounds are having the low melting point and boiling point. Then how water is having high boiling point? Though water is covalent compound, but its boiling point is high, that is 100 degrees Celsius. And it is because of that hydrogen bonding that I am going to explain. See, water has high boiling point 100 degrees Celsius though it is covalent compound. This is due to the strong hydrogen bonding between the associated molecule. Associated molecules means, now see here, here is one water molecule. Now another water molecule is here. So in between these two, there is a hydrogen bonding is there. Okay. Now next, again another example we will see. Here is the another water molecule. So between these, so there is a continuous association. This dotted line represents there is a association between these water molecules, and due to that association of different water molecules, water is having high boiling point, that is the 100 degrees Celsius. Now, if assume that if this hydrogen bond is absent, if there is no hydrogen bond between that water molecule, if hydrogen bonding was absent, water should have boiling point nearly minus 80 degrees Celsius. If there is no hydrogen bonding in the water molecule, then its boiling point will be the minus 80 degrees Celsius. Okay, in the absence of hydrogen bonding, water in the oceans, rivers and lakes would rapidly evaporate. Okay, assume our earth surface covers nearly 70% of water. Okay, and if hydrogen, assume our hydrogen bond is absent in the water, and if it is absent, then there is a continuously evaporation of water from the oceans, rivers and the lake. Okay, it is going to rapidly evaporate. Now second characteristic is that is the dissolution of ionic compound in water. Though both O and H bond in water molecule are covalent, but due to hydrogen bonding, water molecule behave as a polar molecule. Okay, see here, in H2O, as I said, H2O is a covalent compound, but due to that highly electronegative electro pair is shared towards the oxygen, that's why it is behaving as a polar molecule. This hydrogen acquiring part positive and this is acquiring the negative, that's why it is behaving as a polar solvent. And due to the polar nature, it is having very high dielectric constant, and it is going to dissolve the ionic compounds in it. Means the electrostatic force of attraction is broken due to that polar nature. Okay, and water is able to dissolve the various compound in it due to this polar nature. Due to that polar nature, various ionic compounds, they are dissolved in the water. Now next characteristic is the physical state of matter. Okay, hydrogen bonding decides the physical state of matter. Okay, ethane, see here, ethane, formula of ethane is C2H6. It is in gaseous at room temperature due to the absence of hydrogen bonding. On the other hand, water H2O is liquid at room temperature due to the presence of hydrogen bond. Okay, see here, this is the, both are the covalent compound. C2H6, that is the ethane. This is gaseous at the room temperature. This ethane is gas at the room temperature. But H2O, it is a liquid. Liquid at room temperature. Why it is liquid? Because due to the presence of hydrogen bonding in it, it is the liquid at room temperature. And next characteristic, this bond always involve hydrogen atom. Okay, if hydrogen is absent, then there is no hydrogen bonding is there. So there must be the hydrogen atom which is linked with the highly electronegative atom. Okay, so hydrogen bond is weaker than covalent bond and ionic bond, but it is stronger than the van der Waals forces. Okay, after this hydrogen bonding, we are going to start the van der Waals forces or intermolecular attractions. Okay, so these are the five characteristics of water. In that first one, we have seen the BP of, that is boiling point of water. It is 100 degrees Celsius due to the association of different molecules. Secondly, we have seen the physical state. Physical state means ethane, it is a gaseous due to the absence of hydrogen bonding. But water, it is a liquid at room temperature due to the presence of hydrogen bonding. Third, that water dissolve various ionic compounds in it. Okay, due to the polar nature of water, various ionic compounds are dissolved in the water. So that is the solubility. It is going to dissolve ionic compounds in it due to the polar nature. Fourth, we have seen hydrogen bond must involve the hydrogen atom, and hydrogen bond, it is a weaker than the covalent bond or ionic bond, but it is stronger than the van der Waals forces or intermolecular forces. Okay, so this is all about the characteristics of the hydrogen bonding. In exam, question is asked, why water is having exceptionally high boiling point, that is 100 degrees Celsius? The reason for that, it is the due to the association of various water molecules. There is association between the various water molecules. That's why the boiling point of water is high, that is the 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, so this is all about the characteristics of hydrogen bonding. We will stop here. Thank you.